Good afternoon, ladies. Good afternoon. Y'all ready to chat too? I see y'all already chatting. Well, first I would like to give honor to God, Pastor Miller, and any other reverends that are in the room this afternoon. This is a wonderful occasion we are here today.
Yeah.
It's wonderful just to gather again. It's been a minute, at least for me.
Yeah.
It takes me a little while to trust all the news, and so I had to pray and get ready to gather. So I'm glad to see that you too have prayed and ready to gather.
Yeah.
It's a wonderful event that we're here today. We're here for our IMVG Minister Wives and Widows Chat and Chew Social. I am your Mistress of Ceremony, Sister Davis, Pam Davis, that is. Let's see, I think that's okay. Can you hear me? Okay, perfect. So, I'm your Mistress of Ceremony. I am a member of the Rock of Salvation, where Pastor M.L. Brown is the pastor, but I'm also a Hebronite. I started my journey here at Mount Hebron, and this is my home. So I have a quick story to tell. I'm sure you guys remember when you were in elementary, we would get our report cards, and the teacher would actually handwrite in the little squares at the bottom what you needed to improve on or what you was very good at. Well, in my comments was always, Pamela talks too much. Always, my mother would get so upset. She was like, if I get that note one more time. And fast forward 50 years later, my teacher, Sister Miller, she called me and asked me to do the MC. I said, what? You want me to talk? So the little girl in me really, truly appreciates you, Sister Miller. I'm up here very, very excited that I get to talk as long as I want. But no, I'm sure some of you boys out there are thinking, yeah, your teacher is right. You're talking too much. Can we get to the program? So our program is first on the program is the invocation. Then we're going to have a greeting by Angela Wallace, Sister Angela Wallace, I apologize. And the icebreaker by Sister Deborah Allen. And a door prize, at that time, would be drawn by Sister Patsy Allison. And then I'll come back after that. Okay? Thank you.
Let us bow our knees in prayer. O Father in heaven, we just thank you, Heavenly Father, for this hour, for this program that has been put on today for a sweet, loving person. Lord, we ask Heavenly Father that you will bless it, Heavenly Father, that we may, Heavenly Father, continue and grow and put laughter in our heart, Heavenly Father, where we
enjoy this program.
We just thank you, Heavenly Father, for all the blessings.
And now, Sister, do you want me to bless the food too, or what? Bless the food? No, just a prayer. Okay, sorry about that. We
thank you, Heavenly Father, for all your many blessings. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
First, give reverence to God and to our moderator, Pastor C.L. Wallace, to our minister's wife's liaison, Dr. Max Miller, and then to our IBMDA minister's wife, President Sister Rhonda Miller. Let everything that have breath praise you, the Lord.
Amen.
I am so glad to see you here this afternoon. It is indeed a blessing. We'd like for you to relax and enjoy this worship service in the presence of the Lord. Thank you so much for coming out today. And before I sit down, I would like to welcome you to come out on the third Saturdays of each month to our minister's wives meeting. And it's held right here in the great Monopolis city of Houston, Texas at 3221 Southmore Street at the IMBGA building. Again, thank you and welcome.
Amen.
Good evening, everybody. We're going to move the mic down a little bit. Maybe that's what's causing the mic to go in and out. So we're going to have Sister Erin. We're going to have her.
And maybe what the problem is. I don't know if it's a person or what it is. But we're going to see if I can do it pretty good here. So we're going to
thank you.
Sister Deborah
Air. All right, December, woohoo! Thank you. sister. Bill Ellington, August, all right. Pam Davis, he traveled out of the country with his wife. Okay. Andrea Perry, all right. All right, come on, Sister Wallace.
All right. The first person I talked to, I found out was born in October. Miss Dorothy Harris.
All right, Sister Harris. Anderson and Sister Perry. Those are PKs today. And Sister Jennifer Johnson, Brenda Ellington as well. Amen. Thank you, ladies, so much.
Now, get ready for the next one.
Don't worry, we're gonna do at least five right now, so if you pray real hard. the next number, 1, 2, 6, 2, 4, 8. Woo! All right, get excited, get excited. All right, we want to thank our beautiful assistant over there, Mistress of Ceremony. I want to thank her for helping with those little young legs and knees. She can move. All right, get ready, here we go. Next number. 1, 2, 6, 2, 4, 7. All right, that's three, so don't give up. We got two more to go this round. All right, close your eyes and pray, as they say. Here we go. 1, 2, 6, 2, 3, 4. We got it? Okay. All right. Let's see. It's 1, 2, 3, 4. She closed her eyes and she prayed real hard. Okay, we have one more. This round, you're going to have another opportunity. But I'm gonna dig deep. I'm gonna let her out.
All right.
She's gonna really get you now. Okay. Here we go. Get ready. Listen up. 1, 2, 6, 2, 5, 5.
Whether we're in life seasons, your four children, raising children, college children, empty nest, rebound children, and grandchildren. Help us, Lord, whether we're in our spiritual seasons, where God has assigned us to build a relationship, to build a ministry, to plant inside our home, to plant in our community, to plant in our church family, or to plant in our work family. God, give us the wisdom and discernment to know the season that we are in. Help us to shape up the temptation to say our plan and assignment is too hard. Help us to be obedient. Help us to stay committed to your call. Let us not get weary in our well-doing, because we know in due season, he will bless us. Help us, Lord, to be committed until you see that harvest and see your face in the last day. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Mine is a little bit different, but it's real short. I'm talking on the season of growing. So first of all, I want to give honor to the Lord who's head of my life, to my husband, Reverend Dwayne L. Hopkins Sr., to my pastor, Pastor W.L. Roundell Jr. from Greater St. Matthew's Missionary Baptist Church in Hitchcock, and to Moderator Wallace, and to Pastor Miller, and to the President of the IMBGA. Good afternoon, blessed women of God. My name is Keisha Hopkins, and I was asked to do a prayer on season of growth. My prayer, so the definition of season is a time that is that's associated with something that happens every year. So that is that the seasons change so that we are. As we get older, we get wiser, we do not stay in the same mind frame. We start growing like this every year. And the definition of growth is to increase advancement progress. In 2 Peter 3:17 and 18, it says, therefore, dear friends, since you have been forewarned, be on the guard so that you may be carried away by the arrows of the lawful and far from our secure position, but grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Jesus Christ. Obey is exactly what is command. Obey is exactly what God said, it's command. It's like if you have a daughter or son like that, and they have a toy, and you have to do whatever the instructions are saying, that's how you go along with doing it. Serving is being a kingdom of God. You know, me being a servant, being in the medical field, you know, helping out the elderly, and also transitioning, you know, from the next season into becoming a school teacher, working with the special needs kids that are nonverbal. That was something I had never done before, and so that was a position that God has placed me into doing, and I enjoy doing it. You know, I followed along in my mom's footsteps. She was a nurse, and she done it, and I saw how the way that the people were very pleased with her, and so I wanted to do the same thing, to be a servant, not only in for the kingdom of God, but also for as I'm here on earth, you know, and preparing is getting ready, following into the footsteps, you know, never thought that I would be, preparing is getting ready, you know, cause following in my mom's footsteps in the medical field with what I did, but I didn't know that God was preparing me for ministry alongside my husband. I thought it was one thing, but God had another plan. So when you have a plan for you, you know, you have to go like a different way, whatever he has, you know. So in conclusion, seasons have changed in my life, causing me to grow into the woman that y'all see today. Thank you.
Thank you, ladies. Prayer always important, right? It makes you feel good when you pray, when you hear and listen to other people's prayers. It makes your heart beat a little faster. So thank you, ladies, for that. Hebrews Hebrews chapter 3 says, therefore, holy brothers and sisters, who share the heavenly calling, fix your thought on Jesus when we acknowledge as our apostle and high priest. So long as we keep our mind on Jesus, we got a day, right? We're going to be all right. And with prayer too, come on down. So next on our program, we are going to have a solo by Sister Debbie Taylor. Come on, Sister Debbie Taylor, sing in a harmony.
Amen.
wanted to get up and say the words that she was singing in the song. You know how you do that. I can't do that. She did that all by herself, and I had to leave that alone. So thank you so, so much, Sister Denise Taylor. That was beautiful. Good afternoon. Giving honor to God, respect to Pastor Wallace, Pastor Miller, all ministers of Sermon Creek today, to my pastor slash husband, Pastor Cotton, who is not here today, and to all of you, my sisters and brothers in Christ. Indeed, it is a good day to be in the house of the Lord. I want to, first of all, just thank the ladies from Rockin' Start for just showing up. And I also want to point out, it's funny, I probably haven't seen her in about 15 years, but she was probably, is that you, Pat?
Yeah.
The best shortstop is you, six. My hot times have flown by. I am here to speak on the season of harvesting. And we know that harvesting is the process of gathering. And I can tell you, I was on the other side of the process of mankind. I needed to be gathered. Now, I'm in a ministry where I can be a part of the gathering process. So I ask you right now to just bow your hands with me as we pray through this together and ask God to bless the ministry, to bless each and every one of us that are here today, to maybe get us stronger in the Lord. Oh, gracious Master, we come to you this afternoon, giving you all the praise and the honor. Thanking you for allowing us to lay our heads down last night for our early rising this morning. Thank you, O Heavenly Father, give us traffic breaks to make it here safe and sound. Thank you, O Heavenly Father, for any and everything that you blessed us with in and of this day. Before we ask you for anything, O Heavenly Father, we want to just thank you for everything. But Father, we understand that the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. You ask us to come together. Gather those in your name, O Heavenly Father. Lord, I ask you that you just strengthen this ministry on this day as it gathers to bring more men and women into the fold, more men and women so they would know you, O Heavenly Father. Lord, I ask you to bring contentment to us, to make us fearless, O Heavenly Father, to give us patience, O Heavenly Father. Make us content, Father, in understanding that you alone have us where we are at this particular time. Not allow us to jump ahead of your Heavenly Father and do a will according to our way, but understanding it is of your way. Make us fearless, O Heavenly Father. For you said you would never leave us, nor will you ever forsake us, O Heavenly Father. And know that this journey, the process of gathering, it takes time, it takes effort, Heavenly Father, but that you are with us each and every step of the way. And then, Father, God, I want to ask you for continued patience. We all know that we lack patience, O Heavenly Father. Lord God, I ask that you just continue to watch over each and every man, woman, child that's here today, and those who are walking in your faith, O Heavenly Father, those who know you in the part of their sin, O Heavenly Father, those who are gathering, are in the process of gathering, O Heavenly Father, pray that you give us patience. It's a tough world, O Heavenly Father. Not everybody wants to hear your word, O Heavenly Father. Oh God, but I ask that you just continue to give us that patience, continue to strengthen us, as only you know how. I ask all blessings in your Son's name, Jesus Christ.
Ask you for anything, Lord God. We want to acknowledge you for everything, Heavenly Father. We want to acknowledge serve a God that is bigger than any challenge that we can go through. We want to acknowledge, Lord God, that you are a God, Heavenly Father, that is tried and true, Heavenly Father. We want to acknowledge, Lord God, that everything that was in your word, Lord God, is our truth, Heavenly Father. We want to acknowledge, Lord God, that this isn't the first time that we've come to you, Lord God, and asked you to help us in a season of challenge, Heavenly Father. Lord God, but we also want to acknowledge, God, that when we are facing a challenge, Lord God, that we want to also remember, God, that you are God of harvesting, planting, Lord God, and Lord God, that you are God of growth, Heavenly Father. So in all of these seasons, Heavenly Father, Lord God, let us not forget that, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, we want to come before you asking, Lord God, for our challenging seasons, Heavenly Father, asking you for help in the midst of our challenging seasons, Heavenly Father. We want to ask you, Lord God, for wisdom, Lord God, to deal with the seasons that we may be in, whether they are small or whether they are large, whether they have been for a minute, Lord God, or whether they have been for a month, Heavenly Father. We want to ask you, Lord God, that you would give us wisdom, Lord God, to stand, Heavenly God, Father. We ask that you would give us wisdom to know when to sit, Lord God, wisdom to know when to pray, Lord God, wisdom to know when to move, Heavenly Father. We pray, Lord God, that every, Lord God, season that we are sitting in, Heavenly Father, every challenge that we are sitting in, Heavenly Father, we know, Lord God, that it is not, Lord God, the end, Lord God, but that we are just in the midst of it, Heavenly Father, Lord God, that it is not, Lord God, our final destination, Heavenly Father, but that you have something greater for us, Lord God, in this season of challenge, Heavenly Father. Lord God, after we have acknowledged and remembered who you are, Lord God, and in the midst of us asking, Lord God, for you to continue to meet us in our hour of need, Heavenly Father, let us continue to also have a prayer of anticipation in this challenging season, Lord God, knowing, Heavenly Father, that you will bring us through, Heavenly Father, knowing, Heavenly Father, that, Lord God, you are testing us, Lord God, that we may come forth as pure gold, Heavenly Father, Lord God, knowing, Heavenly Father, that you will hear our prayers, Lord God, and this is but for a short time, Heavenly Father, that this is not for forever, Heavenly Father, because you are a God, Lord God, who has determined and desired good things to happen in our seasons, Heavenly Father. Bless us not to forget you in this challenging season, Lord God. Continue to, Lord God, send people to intercede on our behalf in our challenging seasons, Heavenly Father. Lord God, continue to remind us, Heavenly Father, that even in the midst of our challenging season, Lord God, that you are a God of love, Lord God, that you are a God of right, Heavenly Father, and that you loved us enough, Lord God, to not only have us go through this season, Lord God, but that you are with us in this season, Heavenly Father. Once again, we praise you and we thank you, for it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
All right. Everybody run.
You're number one. I'll bring you something shortly. Other than that, ladies, let's go for it. And while we're doing that, I also want to let you guys know I did get permission to the meeting early. You know, when you ask the Lord for something, He always comes through. You just have to wait for it. So I'm very busy. So I have to leave here and go, but our president gave me permission to do that. So thank you guys for being so nice to me.